and welcome. I'm Peja Mujevic, and on behalf of all of us from the Tippet Rise Art Center, welcome to this digital presentation of a concert that the St. Lawrence String Quartet played at Tippet Rise in the summer of 2019. I'm very glad to have with us Geoff Nuttall, the first violinist of the St. Lawrence String Quartet, and I would invite him to say a few words about the program that they played for us that summer.
Thank you, Peja. That was a treat. That's one of the great places to play music on the planet. And it involves music by three great friends of the quartet, one of whom, unfortunately, is long gone. 1809, Joseph Haydn passed. But the two living composers, Oswaldo Golhoff and Jonathan Berger, are really close friends and sort of partners in crime to the quartet. Jonathan Berger is our colleague at Stanford. And Oswaldo Golhoff has been closely connected to the SLSQ since 1992, when he wrote a Yiddish book, his first string quartet for us. So it's an amalgam of these two things, because of course Haydn is the man, Haydn is the father. He was the groundbreaking, life-changing, earth-shattering composer who set in, you know, basically in stone what the quartet could do, and it all started with Opus 20. So we have this Opus 20 number 4, which contains one of the great minuets ever composed. If I always say, if you want to understand the genius of Haydn, you just listen to, you know, random three or four minuets from the 104 symphonies and the 68 quartets, because he had, within the really strict confines that he created, the ABA form and this thing, this endless imagination and inspiring quirkiness. And in this case, this minuet messes with your perceptions and expectations of what a minuet is. So if you try to dance it in three, which was, you know, everybody understood in 1770 when this would have been played at Esterhazy, the minuet was part of the fabric of musical life there. And in this case, he's written the minuet basically in two. So you can imagine the dancers falling onto the floor. Alla Zingarese, he entitles this movement. And this minuet directly inspired Jonathan Berger's tango Alla Zingarese. That's we're putting the two together. Now you won't be able to sing along, but some of the quirkiness, some of the messing with your perceptions of rhythm, you'll hear those in the Berger Alla Zingarese, as well as the Haydn. And Jonathan is really inspired by what Haydn did, and he often uses Haydn's music to illuminate when he talks about music in the brain and expectation and lack there. Is sort of cool. So I love that connection between Haydn Opus 20 number 4 and Jonathan Berger's new piece inspired by this minuet Alla Zingarese. And then Oswaldo Golhoff is, well, maybe I'm biased because he's such a good friend, but he writes so expressively and honestly. It's a really beautiful two movement work. First movement is sort of inspired by a Brazilian pop tune, which you won't really hear. It's sort of embedded in the fabric, but incredible use of color. He has such a distinctive sound, the way he uses the instruments. And the second movement, as he describes it so poetically, is a motorcycle ride where the first violin sort of soars along this motoric accompaniment in the three lower strings. So two new pieces and one of the great groundbreaking works of the quartet repertoire by Haydn. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you so much, Geoff, for setting the stage for this filmed concert. I hope you all enjoyed. Thank you for joining us, and we'll look forward to seeing you next time.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.